gonna go over this and do a trend review. Alright, so let's get rid of all these indications. Okay, so understand that how, from a structure perspective, like just this basic market structure, what you have is accumulation, then you have markup. Alright, so you have accumulation, and then you have markup. Now up here, it's either they're going to sell the highs or sell right after the highs. Okay? And you can call it distribution or minor distribution, doesn't matter. So it's either going to be the climax or right after it, and it comes back down. And then up back here, the pullback buyers step in. And they're either going to do it on the pullback itself or right after some low volume testing. Then they'll reaccumulate. Okay? Then price will go back up, and this area is where it's going to face resistance. Why? Because there were sellers here. So there's the resistance. So it can either go down from this area if the sellers are strong, or it can absorb and go higher. But that's basically the way things work. All right. So you have accumulation, markup, distribution, reaccumulation, either redistribution and goes down, or it's absorbed and it goes higher. So now on the left hand side, I got a chart. This is the YM. It's a higher time frame. And on the right hand side, I got another chart, which is a lower time frame. And I want to explain how this thing happens. So you have a climax up here, right? And you know, like that rally. You see this? See that rally? So on the rally, they had it right at the top. Okay? Now what happens is you come back down, and on the pullback, there could be a reaccumulation. So you see that what happens here is reaccumulation in this area. Now, after that reaccumulation, they're going to try to go back to the rally highs. What happens at the rally highs is very important. Is it able to absorb or go higher, or will it break lower? In this case, it's unable to absorb and go higher. Okay, this resistance is just way too strong. Okay, so it goes up there, does this shit, right? This redistribution. That's what up, all this up down here is. And then it comes back down. When it comes back down to this reaccumulation area, this right here is absorption. This supply absorbing demand, not demand absorbing supply at resistance, but supply absorbing demand at support. And you see the blue bar, and it breaks lower. Okay? So it absorbs, supply absorbs demand, and it breaks lower. Then it goes right back into that area. Right? And it has trouble getting above that area. In fact, it cannot absorb that area. Buyers are not willing to absorb that area. And it thrusts down, goes back here, and comes back down here. Now watch this structure. If you just flip it, you'll see it from the bearish perspective, like what's going on. It goes down here. What you have is accumulation. All right, but understand, this is not the type of accumulation in an uptrend. This is accumulation in a downtrend. All that does is it sets up a counter trend rally to test resistance. See, like here, you have accumulation, then you have reaccumulation. So if I flip it, you have distribution. Oh, God. Hold on. Distribution. That's a D. So you have this. You have selling, then you have some accumulation here, and then it'll come back in this area where there'll be redistribution and it'll go lower. Then you have reaccumulation, okay? But understand, these accumulation or high volume blocks, These are just temporarily supporting the market. Okay, they're not enough to change trend. It just means there are buyers there. Now, why are they buying? Is it because they're short covering? Or is it because of some other reason? You know, this is accumulation in a downtrend, okay, which all that does is it sets up a bounce to test a breakdown. So it's like that counter trend. And now people say, oh, you know, that's no such thing as accumulation like that. Look, accumulation is buying, distribution is selling, and there's minor and major. So you just, I mean, this is reality. This isn't no schematic, all right? So take a look here is where you had that reaccumulation right here, which set up the bounce into this resistance area. Remember, this is a resistance area. And that's where you're going to find sellers. So this is your redistribution block right here, thrusts down and goes. And so what's this over here? This actually is absorption. Okay. Just like you have anytime, typically when you have an area of accumulation, right, people think that that's possible support. So what happens is when you go back into that area, what happens? They're buyers. And in order to break it, many times you're going to need to absorb that area. Supply will have to absorb that area in order to go lower. Same thing here. You have that area of accumulation, came up, distributed at the resistance area, came right back down, where absorption happened, this and this is absorption. This absorption to go lower, not higher. Why? Because supply is absorbing demand at support. Why is it support? Because this was a prior area of accumulation which caused a counter trend rally. So here you have that accumulation which caused a counter trend rally. Someone sold that resistance, came right back into that same area, absorbed it, and guess what happened? It went down. Now this is where you get a change of character. Why? Because this accumulation area, like by now you see the structure, what they're doing, right? Like they accumulate so you can sell at higher prices and distribute, bring it back down, absorb, break, accumulate some more in order to bring it higher, right? So you can distribute at higher prices and then bring it down, absorb, and break lower. But this time it didn't break. You see? There's some change of behavior here. It didn't break. It didn't break the low. What does that mean? That means the downtrend is now in question. Because this time price went here. It's, you know, last time it went to this level, it absorbed and broke through. This time, it's not able to absorb and break. It tried. It tried right there. You see this? This bar, it tried to break. But they did not let it break. Strong hands jumped in right there. Okay. Strong hands said, you're not going lower. And what they did was they rallied, pulled back, and changed. Instead of absorbing support to go lower, now you're absorbing resistance to go higher. See that? So these guys stepped in, and this now they absorb this area, this resistance area, right? And higher. Okay. Now when there's a rally after a rally or on the top of a rally, you have selling some minor distribution in order to go back to support. Right? So it goes down back to support, and guess what? Again, this huge block of accumulation occurred. See this? Okay? So when that happens, that means they're going to try and attempt to go higher. Okay? So this is where the absorption is expected. So they take it right back up here, and it's hanging out. So basically, the point of this is to show that there's actually some degree of structure in the markets between buyers and sellers and what really goes on. All right, this is a rally like this, not random. You know, a rally, down rally like this is not random. You think this is random? No, it's not. All right, so the question is, now the question is what the hell are they going to do up here? Anything can happen, but people with deep pockets will, you know, they will try to push prices in their direction. We can just follow what they're doing, right? So the question is, what happened here? They were selling here, accumulate here, bring it up, but they couldn't get past the selling. So they have to absorb this area in order to go higher and take out the rally high. So you can see very clearly what the structure of the market, I'm not saying all the time because there's no such thing, but basically you got a block of accumulation, right? Accumulation or reaccumulation, whatever you want to call it. Then you got a rally, right? And then either on the rally high or right after it, you have some minor distribution. Then it comes back, and in this area, you have reaccumulation. Then you have, it comes up here where you have absorption. Okay? And they have to go. If they can't, then what happens is price comes back down to this reaccumulation area, right? Here, either it'll absorb and go higher, or what will happen is it will stop at the resistance area, like right there and right here and go down, you know, the ice level. Okay, if that happens, it's going to come back down. It's going to do absorption here and break, come back up to test, come back down, accumulate here in order to cause the bounce, distribute here. This is what's really going on. Now, after looking at a lot of charts and based on my experiences, like, you know, I have visual indicators, stuff like that, to just help me see this clearer. But anyway, let's take a look at the lower time frame, and you will see the structure as well. You see what happened on Friday? They set up the trade. You had a rally, right? Then what happens? After rally, there's some selling that makes it comes back down here, right? And what do they do here? Reaccumulate. Right? That's what I've been saying. And when they reaccumulate, they're going to take it right back to the high in order to absorb. But this time, it went up. It's trying to absorb, but really what happened here was distribution, because it tried to absorb in this block and it couldn't go higher. So it's supposed to absorb in this block, but the other condition is you can distribute at the resistance area, right? At the rally high. So right here is where the distribution occurred, and they went right back down to this area of reaccumulation, and bang, broke it. See that? Broke it. Now, there's a problem, because that's your indication that trend has possibly changed. So now they go back into this area to test, and redistribution occurs. And bang. Okay? So, this is what you're seeing. Like, they have a rally. They're going to try to sell and break, but there's no follow through. So, what happens? Buy the pullback. They come in, bing, and come up here. Right, there's your range, break out, test, same area, take it higher. Then come back at the same pullback area, buy, take it to resistance, see if they can take it out, try to absorb. Absorption fails, distribution occurs, and break. So this is what I see in the market. Now, other folks will have different ideas of how they view the market. You know, maybe they just draw a range and look for up thrust and springs and look for failures. But if you're looking at it from a supply and demand fighting each other, right? Supply and demand fighting each other in order to push prices up or down, then I think that this perspective of viewing it from the perspective of accumulation, reaccumulation, you know, distribution, redistribution, and absorption, and then follow through is an excellent way of thinking about the markets as it moves from point A to point B, breaking support and resistance levels or failing at those support and resistance levels, those levels of high volume, where there are obviously sellers and buyers. Anyway, so this is just a perspective of looking at the markets. And I like this perspective because this is real. Like, this is not something in a book that some guy put a channel. Right? This is what you see. This is the accumulation. Right here. Bang. Goes up. Goes to resistance. They're going to try to absorb this area. If they can't, it's going to go right back into that accumulation to see if there's support. If there's no support, they will absorb and go lower. If there is support, they'll take it back into this area and try to absorb it to go higher. So this is the way supply and demand are fighting each other, right? They're jockeying for position to take price higher or lower. All right, that's all. Thanks.